Patient care and service employees of the UC Jacobs Medical Center in La Jolla use their lunch break to rally outside the hospital.
Treat your workers like you should.
This is one of three local rallies at UC campuses that joined thousands across the state to protest the pay gap between UC employees and the governing members of the university system.
UC knows the price of everything and the value of nothing.
Sean McCullum is the lead organizer of the American Federation of State, County, and Municipal Employees, Local 3299, the union that represents 6,000 hospital and service workers. He says the rallies were happening at the same time the UC Board of Regents was voting on giving their chancellors raises. They're asking for all employees to make a minimum of $25 an hour.
They give their chancellor a $500,000 raise, so he makes over $1.2 million now. The CEO here at the medical center, she makes $1.4 million. These raises have gotten out of control for the executives, and then they're saying they don't have money to help ordinary employees who save lives.
Isaac Zamora, a respiratory therapist, joined the rally line on his break.
99!
He says he was disappointed when he found out the regents were voting on giving those at the top of the pay scale another raise.
It made me feel that they really don't care about the work that we do here.
Especially when he sees his colleagues struggling to get by.
The chancellor for UCSD, they approved a 79% raise for him over 1 year. 79%. Meanwhile, we're out here asking for 5% just to keep us up so we can afford milk and bread. It stings. I can't say it doesn't. It stings.
He says those on the front line are now forgotten, and the people who stayed home during the pandemic and often still work from home continue to get the rewards. His message for the Board of Regents as they vote for a raise is simple.
To reconsider and think about the workers before you think about yourself.
They're also asking for the UC system not to invest in Blackstone, a company they say is contributing to the housing crisis. Kitty Alvarado, KPBS News.